complex fractions. We're going to multiply everything by the LCD. Only the numerators, though. We're not trying to get a common denominator. We are trying to eliminate all our denominators like we were with the complex fractions. And we're going to solve for x. It is essential that you check your solutions here. Okay? You have to check your solutions because sometimes we're going to end up with something that we call an extraneous solution, and we should not include that in our final answer. All right? So let's look at an example. Okay, 3x over 2 is equal to x over 5 minus 39 over 5. Now, there are a couple of different ways that we could approach this problem. Number one, it is different from our warm-up because it is not simply a rational expression set equal to another rational expression. We have two rational expressions on the right side. Now, this one is pretty simple because the two on the right side could be combined because they have a common denominator. So let's do that, and then I'm going to show you how it works out if we did it exactly according to the steps we just wrote down. So like I said, the two expressions on the right side have the same denominator, so that means that we can simply combine them into a single rational expression. Now we do have something like the warm-up, okay? We have a fraction equal to a fraction, or a rational expression equal to a rational expression. So we can cross-multiply. So we get 15x is equal to 2x minus 78. Solve for x, so we need to move the 2x. 13x is equal to negative 78. Divide by 13, and we get x is equal to negative 6. We do need to check that. So plug it into the left side, 3 times negative 6 divided by 2. We get negative 9 on the left side. On the right side, make sure you put these expressions in parentheses so that your calculator follows the correct, or oops, I had a plus instead of a divide. There we go. Negative 9. Okay, so both sides do equal negative 9. Now, let's look at what we would do if we followed the steps exactly. Okay, looking at our denominators, we've got 2 and 5 in the denominator, so our LCD here would be 10. So if we multiply each of these by 10, okay, 10 over 2 reduces to 5, so we have 5 times 3x. 10 over 5 reduces to 2, so we have 2 times x, minus 10 over 5 is 2, 39 times 2. Notice this is looking very similar to what we just did. 2x minus 78, and obviously that's the exact same thing right there. It's going to end up the same way. This was just a very simple example. Let's see what happens when we throw some more variables in there. Okay, let's see what happens when our rational expression gets a little bit more complicated. Something like 1 over x is equal to 1 fifth plus 3 over 2 x. We cannot simply combine those two rational expressions on the right side because they don't have the same denominator. Now, technically, we could go through the process of getting a common denominator, but it is easier to figure out what your LCD would be and then multiply everything by the LCD. So, first of all, from the first denominator, we have an x. Then we get 5 and 2. They don't have anything in common. Their least common multiple is 10. And we already have that x that shows up in the last one. Okay, so our LCD is 10x. Let's multiply each expression by 10x. So for the first one, the x's cancel, so we have 1 times 10. The second one, 10 over 5, is 2, so we have 1 times 2x. Don't forget your plus sign right here. And 10 over 2 is 5, and the x's cancel, so we've got plus 3 times 5.
So let's solve. 10 is equal to 2x plus 15. Subtract 15. Negative 5 is equal to 2x. So negative 5 over 2 is our x. You have to be very careful when you check answers, particularly when they are fractions. 1 over, put negative 5 over 2 in parentheses. If you don't put it in parentheses, it will not turn out the way it's supposed to. 1/5 plus 3 over, you've got to put parentheses around the entire denominator because it's got 2 times x, and then you still have to put parentheses around the negative 5 over 2. But you still get that negative 0.4 is equal to negative 0.4. Okay? Now, negative 0.4 is not the answer. Okay, negative 0.4 is just what the two sides of the equation equal when you plug in the answer. So be careful with that. All right, so...